Hello everyone, I am Nikhil Kumar. Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are diving into an essential feature of AWX, that is approval workflow. If you are deploying a critical infrastructure like load balancer directly into production, you will love how approval workflow adds that extra layer of security and control. First, let's quickly understand what approval workflows are. In AWX, an approval workflow is a mechanism that pauses the automation at a predefined point until someone manually reviews and approves this. So in this particular diagram, you can see this particular workflow, it got paused and it's waiting for someone to approve this. Once it got approved, it moved to the another job template to execute those things. That particular user should be having access to approve this particular workflow after reviewing the changes. This is particularly useful in scenarios like deploying sensitive changes in production where manual intervention is critical. In today's video, we will create a workflow that includes a manual approval step before deploying a load balancer in a production environment. Let me log into this AWX instance. So if you see, there is a tab of workflow approvals in this. So it's empty right now. So it will give an option to approve, deny, and delete to a specific user to whom we are providing access. So right now I'm logged in with the admin user. In my previous video, I covered the RBAC user management and the team creation. So I would recommend to check that particular video because that is a foundation for this particular workflow approval. So let's start by creating a workflow job template. For that, we need to go inside the templates and click on add workflow template. So inside that, we are going to give a name that is workflow deploy load balancer with approval. So I'm adding a organization into this and click on save. And now I'm going to add a approval node in this. So for that, in this, we need to go for the approval. Earlier we have added the job template, or like we can add the workflow, but in this we are going with the approval. So this is to approval node for review and save. Now we need to add another job template that will be deploying a load balancer. So it will be on success. Once someone approves it, then only it will trigger that particular job template. That is to configure a load balancer. That is now save. Now we need to add an access to this particular workflow. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a user in this. That is a manager. Next. So this particular user can approve or deny a workflow approval node. So let's save this. And if we go here, this is our workflow, which is to deploy a load balancer with the approval. Now, when someone triggers this particular workflow, it will go to the manager to approve or review these changes. Once manager approves this, it will go to the configuration of the load balancer. Let me do one thing. Let me log in with the manager and the developer user, which we created in our last video. So let's log in with the developer one here. And in another tab, I'm logging with the manager. So now I am logged in with the manager to review the changes and developer to execute the job. I missed something. I need to add that particular developer or the dev team to that particular job template. So let me do it very quickly so that they can execute the job, because we have, like in the last video, we have added the dev team to the configure load balancer only. So let me quickly edit those things as well. Access, add user, and instead of this, we will be going with the team now. So this team should be having access to execute this particular workflow. Save. As we can see now, all the members of this team is having access on this particular workflow to execute, and manager is having an access to approve and as a system auditor. Let me quickly log in with the developer one to execute the workflow. So let's go to the job template, and now we can see the another job template or the workflow, that is deploy load balancer with an approval. And if we want to see the visualizer, we can see the visualizer, but we won't be able to edit this thing. We can click here and we can see the information about this. Let me launch this. Now it's waiting for an approval. If you see, we got some notification pending workflow approval, and it is there is an option to manage those things like approval or denial. Let me go to the manager, and here we can see the notification. And once I approve this, it will execute the job template, that is to configure a load balancer. I approve this. Let me quickly go back to the another tab, that it jobs. And if we see here, it got approved and it moved to the configure load balancer. So this particular job template will execute an NCPL playbook to install and configure the load balancer. Imagine this in a real world scenario. Your team wants to ensure every production deployment is reviewed before execution. Approval workflow make this possible, saving you from unplanned downtime or errors. It got completed and we can see this job template worked fine as well. If I execute it again and denied it, it will not be able to move to the another part, that is to configure load balancer. Let me quickly move to the another one. We got another workflow, that is to, I'm going to deny this. And if we go back and we can see it got failed because we denied that. So this is very powerful feature in the AWS to get a review access to some of the another user, that is your manager, some auditors, so that they can manage those things and review the changes before deploying something to the production. That's it for today. We explored approval workflow in AWS and created a real world example. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.